Hey guys, it's great to see you again. This lecture is the first time in the course we really talk about Firebase. We'll learn how to install Firebase and integrate it into our app. Of course, the course can be taught using a different back-end framework, but the main point of this course is to how to let you learn to build iOS apps in depth and to learn to talk with the back-end guys. Alright, Firebase is a back-end service. Its mission is to handle all kinds of complicated back-end tasks and provide us, the developers, with simple interfaces, so that we can entirely focus on building the app front-end and effortlessly interact with the back-end via these simple interfaces. In other words, Firebase is kind of like a back-end guy in your team, and your job is to learn to communicate well with him. All right, before moving ahead to install and integrate Firebase, let's clear something out first. In the pricing section, you can see that it's free to build and test your app with Firebase. So it's great to quickly build out your apps and hand them to customers to validate your ideas. The free plan gives you 100 simultaneous connections, which should be enough to test your ideas. At $25 per month, we got unlimited simultaneous connections. The real-time database is 1 GB for free plan. Paying $25 gives you 2.5 GB per month. You can see all other information such as for real-time data and for data storage for free and premium plans. We think the free plan is probably enough for us to validate the ideas. The premium plan is not that expensive though. All right, the whole point is we are using the free version to play around with Firebase. Now, Firebase is owned by Google, so we need a Google account to work with it. If you have a Google account already to use, use it. Otherwise, it's free and easy to create one. Here, we already logged in with our Google account, so let's go to the App Console. Alright. Okay. Alright, here's our Firebase App Console. If we want our app to use Firebase backend, we need to create a Firebase project, then link it to our iOS app. This dashboard is where we manage our Firebase projects. Let's create a new Firebase project for our social network app. And name it whatever you like. Then hit Create Project. All right, it's being created. Let's wait a little bit. It might take a while depending on your current network traffic and other things. Okay. All right, it seems to be loading. All right, great. Here is the dashboard for the project we're just created. The next step is to tell Firebase that we want to use this new Firebase new project to back our iOS app. We do that by inputting our iOS app bundle ID, which can be found in the project information. It's in fact this bundle identifier of our project. All right, let's copy it over. All right, the others are optional, so we don't need to worry about them now. Now click Add App to see what we need to do next. Okay. All right, okay, a plist file was automatically downloaded to our machine. Firebase tells us to move to the project root and stuff, so let's do it. Okay. Right, all right, here's the file. The name is a bit off because I downloaded a similar file before, so let's rename it to match its default name. All right, let's see. We need to drag it to the project, so let's open the project in Xcode. Remember to drag it to the root of the project as required by Firebase. Also remember to check add to targets stuff as required by Firebase. Good. Let's now go back to Firebase to see what we need to do next. To use Firebase, we need to install its library and related dependencies. To do so, we use CocoaPods, as that's what Google uses. CocoaPods is a dependency manager specifically for Swift and Object-C. Like, if you need any Swift or Object-C library, you can use it to install the library. And itself needs to be installed on our machine first. After you installed it, here's how to use it. This is a simple example showing how to use CocoaPods to install some iOS libraries. Let's do it for our app. The first step Firebase asks us to do is to run the command pod in its terminal. So let's open your terminal to run this command. A quick way to open terminal is holding command and hitting space, then search for terminal. We need to do this in the app directory, so use the cd command. then drag the project in the terminal. We're now in the project location. We need to jump back to the folder containing the project using the cd... command. Good, this is our project directory. To see where you are, you can use the open... command. This will open the current directory. We're indeed operating in the directory of the project. Alright, let's go back to terminal to run pod init. To see what it gives us, look at the project directory. This command creates a pod file. You can use any text editor to open this file, like the free Sublime 3 text editor. In this file, we tell pod what we want to install in what language for which app. Next, Firebase tells us to add this line to the pod file. This means we want pod to know that we want to install the Firebase core library for our app. Don't forget to save the change. And the last step is to let pod actually install whatever we specified beforehand in the pod file. Alright, after this step, an Xcode workspace file will be created for our app. This is sort of our app with all the libraries installed using pod. From now on, we need to work with this file instead of the original project file if we want our project to be able to use those libraries. Alright, having Firebase installed doesn't mean it will run automatically. We need to import Firebase and do some configuration in the App Delegate class, so that our app can connect to Firebase when it runs. Alright, before to close down the original Xcode project, we're going to use the new one with Firebase installed. Okay, let's see. Our project now has pods part, which contains pod stuff. You can see the pod file here, which is the one we created before. Now, let's open the App Delegate to do import and configure Firebase. In the App Delegate, we typically do some initial setup for the app when it starts running. So it's a perfect place to let the app connect to the database when it launches. Alright. Let's see what Firebase requires. We first need to import the Firebase library, which we install with pod. Then, we can use a FireApp object to perform configuration in the application did finish launching method. Basically, we want to perform some configuration and hook up our iOS app and our Firebase project when the app launched. Okay. Alright, here it is. The console details the configuration process. If you want, you can take a look at it to see what we've been doing during this period. Alright, we'll start working with Firebase next time. See you then!